Hey guys, so I'm actually editing this in after I made the video because I think it'll be helpful. If you guys look in the top of the description, I'm going to pin a comment linking to all parts in this video. So if you only want to see the calculations, there'll be a time link to that you can click on. If you just want to see the method, there'll be a link to click on that. But I hope you guys do enjoy this video. Hey, what is up everybody, and welcome to a new video. In this one, what we're going to be doing is testing the new Czar Thieving, which was added with the new fight kibs. So for this, what you're going to want to be wearing here is full rogues, excluding the gloves. So you're going to want to have the mask, top, trousers, and boots. You're also going to want to have ice gloves. You need these, so make sure you have them. Also, you need a thieving cape, so you have to be 99 thieving for this method, which is probably going to exclude a lot of people off the bat. You also need dodgy necklaces. These can be made with new silver jewelry and opals. What the dodgy necklaces do is give you a 25% chance of not taking any damage if you fail to thieve an NPC, so it's nice for longer trips. Also for this, I'm going to be using fairy rings. So if you have a fairy ring in your house, you can bring a house tab. If you have the diary done to not need the Draymond staff, you won't need the Draymond staff. So I don't have it in my house and I don't have the diary done, so I'm just going to be wearing the slayer ring and the Draymond staff. Now for your inventory, what you're going to want, you don't need the TOKKUL up here, but you do get TOKKUL thieving, so I'm just going to put a placeholder up here. I recommend you guys bring two more dodgy necklaces, and I also recommend you bring three Cerebrews. Another thing you're going to need is a gem bag. If you don't have the gem bag, you're not going to be able to do this. This is 100% needed. So this inventory setup right here normally lasts me between 30 and 40 minutes. It's normally upwards of 40 minutes before you have to bank, and it takes like a minute to bank. So your trips will be pretty long. Also, one thing I forgot to mention is you do have to have the Arty Hard Diary completed. This gives you, I believe, a 10% chance of pickpocketing success around the game. So once you have all of this and you're ready to go, either teleport your house if you have a fairy ring in it, or teleport. What I do is I go to Relica, and I use that fairy ring there, but you're going to want to use the code BLP, and what this is going to do is put you right at the entrance. You need a fire cape to get in here. As many of you know, you don't have to sacrifice it, you just have to show it to this guard right here, and he'll let you through. So once you go through, what we're going to be doing here is running down south. You can basically just follow where I go. I could probably just show you on the map right here to make it a little bit quicker. So we're going to be going right here, which is pretty much close right next to me anyway. So once you guys get over here, I'll show you what to do next. So our goal for this is to get this NPC right here trapped between these two spots right here. So the way you're going to want to do this is actually follow him. You're going to want to start up here and then move all the way through this way. Just stay behind him and make sure he can't walk through you back up. But if you stay behind him, eventually he'll end up in this corner over here. There's also a few other spots he can get trapped in, but this is the one I like using the most. So you can pickpocket him as well when you're going around here. As you're getting him into the corner. So I finally managed to get him in the corner here. What you're going to do once you get him up here, and like I said, you follow him east. So he'll end up being like this, and this is the only square he can walk to. He can't walk anywhere over here. He has to walk north. So basically what you're going to do is sit here and pickpocket him. Once he walks north, you're going to stand behind him. And now he's trapped in the corner, he can't move, so you're going to pickpocket him for 4 minutes. You guys can set up a timer if you want to. The reason we're doing 4 minutes is because after 5 minutes, he actually disappears and despawns from being trapped. It's something Jagex added into the game. So after 4 minutes of pickpocketing him, all you have to do is take one step to the west, let him walk out, and then let him walk back in, and then start your timer again. So that's what you do. You could, like I said, you can sit here for about 30 to 40 minutes between trips. All you have to do is fill up your gem bag when your inventory starts getting full. And that's pretty much it. I have tested it for an hour already. I got 250k XP. So I'm going to be testing this for 9 more hours. So we have a 10-hour testing period. And I'll show you guys how many gems I have and actually what you do with all of the TOKKUL you get as well, because you're going to be using that TOKKUL to actually buy more gems from the store. But I'll see you guys in 9 hours.
So it's been 10 hours here, and it's pretty consistent. 250k per hour over the 10 hours. You'll see I did gain 2.5 mil XP. A few things worth noting here. One, if you try to do this at 90 thieving, it's going to be really bad. You're going to be getting like 90k per hour, so don't attempt to do this unless you're 99 thieving. Another thing is you need to be doing this alone. If you have another person here in the world with you, since you do fail, the XP rates are going to drop from 250k to 210k, so make sure you're doing this by yourself. So the next step in this, after you finish doing the thieving, is going to be spending the TOKKUL to actually buy gems from the new gem store. And you'll see on the map where this is at, it's in the southeastern corner. And if you look up a little bit further from that, you'll actually see where the bank is at in the northeast corner. But basically, all you do here is you hop through the worlds buying the gems and fill them up in your gem bag while you're going. And then you run northeast when you need to bank and just run back down here. It's pretty simple. Each hour you do, you're going to spend about 3.5 minutes buying gems. So over the 10 hours, I'll probably spend about 30 minutes
buying gems, so it's pretty good. And one more thing too, you guys are going to hit hop limits with this. I don't know how many worlds you can hop. I think it's about 20-25, but once you hit hop limits, you can either sit here and alk, you can go sit at the bank and do like fletching or something, but you're going to wait 5 minutes between the world hopping until you're allowed to world hop again. So we finished with all of the gem buying. So this is the amount of gems I ended up with after 10 hours and 32 minutes. 10 hours of thieving and 32 minutes of buying gems. So if you take all these gems and cut them and make the emeralds and sapphires into amulets and the rubies and diamonds into bracelets, this is 664,000 crafting XP banked, which means that over the period of time, it's around 63k crafting XP banked per hour. So one more thing worth noting as well, I don't plan to do Zora on this account or Lava Runes, and that's the reason I'm making the Sapphires and Emeralds into Amulets, because Amulets give the most XP. For people who do plan to do Zora, you're probably going to be making them both into Rings, since they're going to be really useful as Rings of Recoil, obviously, for Zora, and the Emeralds you'll probably be using for maybe Lava Runes. So the XP rates will be a little bit different, but really not that much. So now comes the bit for all you main accounts out there that aren't playing on Iron Man. So if we go and price check all of this, it's a little bit over 6 mil. So this means that I got about 600k per hour if you go and sell all this in the GE. And if you get the same amount of XP, which you do as Arty Knights with full rogues, as you guys know, you get about 300k coins per hour. So this is pretty much the same XP as Arty Knights, but double the profit. So I don't know what the gems are going to be like, the prices on these, after I make this video, but somebody else has done the math, and if you actually buy the Onyx from the store, you're probably going to be making around the same GP if you end up doing 200 mil here. So if these gem prices do drop, the Onyx will always be safe to buy, since that's really not going to drop from this method. So I figured I'd throw this one in here as well. I did finish cutting all of the gems, and I got 319k XP just from cutting them. So if you guys for some reason want to do this just for the cutting XP from the gems and then sell the cut gems, you'll still be getting a pretty decent amount of XP from it. I was planning on finishing all of these for this video, but sadly it's going to take a lot longer than I would have wanted it to, and I wouldn't be able to post this video today. But I did test an hour of this to see how many I can make, and I was able to make 1,231 amulets in an hour, and it's consistent across all these with the bracelets and everything. So I'm just going to use that to figure out how much longer it would take me. Alright, so I tried to put this together into a few pictures the best I could, and there's going to be this one and another one. So as I said before, it's 664,715 crafting XP banked, and this is if you make the emeralds and sapphires into amulets and the rubies and diamonds into bracelets, as mentioned before. And it's going to be about 63k crafting XP bank per hour, but I did tell you guys those two numbers earlier in the video. So if you're going to be selling the uncuts you get from this, it's going to be 600k GP per hour and 250k thieving XP per hour. As mentioned earlier, this is the same XP as Arty Knights, but you get double the profit. So I don't know what the gem prices are going to be after this. I don't know how many people are going to go and do this, but like I said, if you go and buy the Onyx and you save your TOKKUL for it, the Onyx price is going to be a little bit more consistent here, and there's only one in the shop per world. So it's not like people can keep buying them out. Like if there's a bunch of people camping the gem stores, you can just buy the Onyx instead. So this next picture is probably going to be a little bit more helpful to Iron Man. This is the whole reason I was testing it, because these are the numbers that I wanted to know. So it took 632 minutes to do the thieving and buying the gems, as you guys know, the 32 minutes for buying the gems and the 10 hours for actually doing the thieving. So it took 110 minutes cutting all the gems, 234 minutes to make all the amulets and bracelets. So the total time from start to finish was 976 minutes. So if we were to take the amount of crafting XP I would have gotten from this, like I told you guys, I wasn't able to finish actually crafting them all in time, but I can still calculate how much XP I'll end up with. If you take the amount of crafting XP, obviously, and divide it by the amount of time, it's going to be about 41k crafting XP per hour from start to finish. Like I said, this includes the thieving, buying the gems, cutting all the gems, everything. You're going to get 41k. So that's really, really good, considering that if you look under it, you're also going to be getting 169k coins per hour and 154k thieving XP per hour. So all of this over time is really good for Iron Man. Charters, you can get, I believe, 70-75k crafting XP per hour. But from everybody that's tested this so far, over time, this is going to be efficient if you plan to do post-max thieving. And of course, this is also good if you need gems for like killing Zola or something, you need a bunch of sapphires, if you need emeralds for doing lava runes. But overall, this method is really, really good, especially for main accounts. If it's going to be 600k per hour, you're going to make like 480 mil doing 200 mil thieving here. But I hope you all did enjoy this video. I hope you got some use out of it. I'm hoping this method will still be useful after posting this video. I mean, there's a lot of requirements to it, so I don't know how many people are actually going to go and do it. And like I said, even if there's a lot of people doing it, you don't really have to worry about the gem shops, because you can just buy the Onyx if you have to. But yeah, we'll see what happens, guys. I really do hope this stays the way it is right now. The next hardcore video will probably be out in 2 to 3 days, so look forward to that, and I'll see you guys later.